Woolsey, president of Wayne's Wicked Enterprises. Our company is dedicated to making state-of-the-art firearm safety and game recovery products. This year we've come out with what people are saying to be the greatest way to check the wind and thermals in low to no light. It also is one of the best ways to track game, so you always recover the game that you end up harvesting in the evening. The first product I want to show is the Activator. This is what it looked like in the package. See, what the Activator does is it takes the magic dust, which is a phosphorescent powder. It glows in the dark. It's made out of rock. It's absolutely scent-free, and it reactivates indefinitely, which means once you activate this with a light source, it'll do it for 100 years from now, which makes it really unique. This Activator that I'm showing you right here, you can take the magic dust out of the hanging indicators and pour in. There's a glow here that protects it from any kind of moisture. But you just pour it in here, and as you can see, there's a black light built in. And this activates the magic dust. It's reading in a wavelength. So it just takes it 3 or 4 minutes. I like to let it about 5 to 10 minutes if I can. Periodically, if you'll just shake it around, just like that, about every minute. If you do this for about 5 to 10 minutes, this will stay activated for about 30 to 45 minutes. So you can do it all internally. Now, what you can also use this for is you can take the bottom of this by leaving the globe in, keeping the moisture out, like I said earlier, and now you can activate your magic dust that are in the vials, or you can activate even the barrel bumper, which comes with our rifle reel package to keep you from being shot in low light. Failure to identify target is what it'll hopefully cut down on. So that's the Activator. You just pop the top, you compress that, and the powder's going to come out. The nice thing is it's not just going to come out in front of you like doing a regular powder or maybe even some of the little cloth. What this is going to do when you activate is you're going to see it all the way down to the ground, which can be 20 feet. So what's happening up here and what's happening down at the ground are two different things. Also, when it's usually low light and you don't want to be seen, you can check the thermals in mountainous areas. So as you puff it, as the sun comes up, you'll start seeing this dancing, which is telling you that the thermals are rising. The second thing we have is the magic dust and the indicators. And what these do, say these are a really neat tool. You can hang these on trees and you can range find. And again, Mother Nature, any kind of light source, is activating these. So in the evening hunt, no matter how long these hang in the same place, they're going to reactivate. And so the evening hunt, you do not have to do anything to them. As it gets low light, that lasts 30 minutes, you really can't see through your range finders. So this is going to stay activated though. It's going to be working for you. Now you can take those as well and you can sprinkle that down on your blood trails. I like to use it more than the Activator because the Activator missed it very, very fine. So what I like is I like to use something more like the indicators to sprinkle down on the blood trail. Now I've had several hunters that are professional hunters, basically they've got it in their careers. And they've come back and even said as they're blood trailing, what has happened is they've actually lost their way back to the four-wheeler where they started. And by looking around with light, and they were just using a flashlight, they found the blood track with the magic dust in it, and they were able to trail that back to their gear, and which was a four-wheeler. They turned on the lights and got the other two guys that were actually lost as well. So once they got there, they started out and turned the lights on to let them know where they actually started from. But this stuff is really good for a hunter's trail as well. The other thing you can do with it, you can take and you can pour it down into a scrape. Now video cameras or the game cams, they're really good to tell you that there was game there, but they don't tell you where that game went, which direction, did they actually urinate in the scrape, at what time did this take place. You can take these indicators just like this. Just pop your top, sprinkle this right down into your scrape. Again, this is rock, there's no scent, zero. Sprinkle it down in there. Now the next evening or that evening or the next morning, whatever, come back through and you're going to see where the deer actually came through. You'll also see if they urinated very quickly. So now you know if it's a hot scrape, if it's just the deer has come through to check the scrape, and you know the direction because they're going to get it on their feet, on their hooves. So they're going to walk off with this on the pads and you'll see it for 10, 15, 20 yards sometimes. So it gives you the direction that these deer are traveling, whether it's morning or evening. One of the other things you can do with it is very neat, and this happened, you know, it's an after the fact, but I started mixing it with my feather dry. So now when you're taking the feather dry, you put it into a Ziploc bag just like this, take and sprinkle some magic dust in here. Because again, I don't know if you can see it on here, but we are going to take this, and you can activate this. And you can see where this stuff immediately starts glowing. So by activating this, just like this, after you take your feather and put it in here, work this in. It's going to waterproof your feathers, just like you normally would. But now what you're ended up doing is you're going to get this on there. So what's very nice about this is when you shoot at a deer, if you get a pass through, you are going to find your arrow, because you're going to find this. It's going to be glowing in the evening. But if you hit that opposite shoulder, what happens a lot of times, you don't get a blood trail immediately because it did not open up. It hit that opposite shoulder, there's no hole. Until the arrow starts moving around, well, you get a blood trail most of the time. So as this arrow is going, you can't really see it here, but we'll demonstrate this in a few moments. You'll see this falling off. And not only will you have an impact of this stuff after it gets dark, but you're gonna see where this is hitting trees and bushes, and you're gonna figure out where that first 20, 30 yards that deer went, when you never would know that unless you were filming it. There'd be no idea where that deer went. The only way to know this is by using this type of product, it flipping out as you're going off on the trees and bushes, which again, in game recovery in early October, that's the problem, is it's too hot to leave game overnight, so you must find it, or it's just a waste of kill, which none of us like to do. We all want to be humane. Now, when you range find with these things, like I say, take and put about 20, 30 yards, and in the morning, use the bottom of your activator. Or you can take and you can use, again, something like this, little headlamp clip. I like to use a black light, a dark light, because what it ends up doing is if your eyes don't adjust to a bright light like a flashlight, your eyes stay nice and focused to the more of the dark. So if you are looking for a blood trail, it makes it easier to find it. One last thing too. We make the barrel bumper that's very nice because it'll clip on your firearm, and it's going to keep you from being mistaken for game in low light when you're hauling game in and out. But while you're hunting, especially on the ground for turkey hunting, you know, most of all, in full camo or when you're bow hunting early season, there's squirrel hunters out there, so they will be shooting in trees. Take the magic dust, activate it, hang it up pretty high above you on each side, especially when I'm hunting with youth hunter. Get it up here, it emits the low light for 30 minutes at least. So get it up, let everybody know you're in the woods. Animals don't see this stuff, it's emitting such a low light. What we'll have to do, and you'll see in a little bit, we'll demonstrate by activating this, is you've got to be in extreme low light for even our eyes, like a video camera, to pick it up. But what's amazing is how your eyes as a human being does pick this stuff up.